In this segment, we'll talk about if a set of vectors is linearly independent, then if we take a subset of those linearly independent vectors, that subset is also linearly independent. So let's suppose let us be given m vectors. So if we are given m vectors and it is given that this set, let us be given m vectors and this set is linearly independent. So you're given a set of m vectors and people are saying that, hey, these m vectors which are given to you are linearly independent. And then let's suppose we take a subset. Let us take a subset of p vectors. So out of these m vectors, we're going to take a subset of p vectors. So of course, we'll assume that p is less than m. And we can also assume p is less than or equal to m, but we already know for m vectors, they are linearly independent, so we don't need to prove it for exactly m vectors because it's already given to us. So I'm going to take a subset of p vectors, p number of vectors, where p is less than m. And let this subset be as follows. Let it be AA1, AA2, comma all the way up to AAP. I'm not calling them A1, A2, A through AP because those are not the vectors I'm necessarily taking. I'm taking some P vectors out of all these M vectors which are given to me. So that's why I'm just giving them different names than, let's suppose, A1, A2, A3, and so on and so forth. So these are the vectors, let's suppose, is a subset of these M vectors, and I've chosen P of them. Then a linear combination of these vectors will be what? I'll have AA1 times K1, let's suppose, then I'll have another linear combination, AA2, and all the way up to KP, AAP. This will be a linear combination of these P vectors. And let's suppose if I put these equal to 0 vector, what I need to show is that K1, K2 up to KP equal to 0 is the only solution possible for this linear combination being put equal to 0 vector. Now, how do I do that? Is by knowing that, hey, if I have these P vectors which I have chosen, there are M minus P vectors left over. So if I have chosen P vectors out of the M vectors, I got M minus P vectors left over, which I am not including in this subset. And let's suppose if I call those vectors to be AA, P plus 1, all the way up to AM, AAM. So I have those, these are my M minus P vectors which I have left over. Then what I can do is I can write this. I can say, okay, hey, I've got K1, AA1 vector plus K2, AA2 vector plus KP, AAP vector. Then what I'll do is I'll put 0 times the other vectors which I have left over. I'll put 0 plus this thing plus 0 times AAP plus 2 vector plus all the way up to 0 AAM vector and put that equal to 0. So what I'm basically doing is to this linear combination put equal to 0 vector, I'm adding a 0 because all these extra vectors which I have, these m minus p vectors which are left over, not extra, but m minus p vectors which are left over, they are multiplied by 0. So this is same as this. But if you look at this, this is a linear combination of all the vectors which I have, all the m vectors which I have. And I know that if I take the linear combination of all the m vectors and I put that equal to 0 vector, the only possible solution is k1 equal to 0, k2 equal to 0, all the way up to km equal to 0. But I already assume that the other ones are 0. I already put them as 0. So that means that that's the only solution possible. So if somebody told me, hey, what is the what is the solution corresponding to this linear combination for the 0 vector, I'll have to say, hey, the only combination possible is that it's a trivial solution. That means that this has to be 0, this has to be 0, this has to be 0. This would have been 0 whether I would have assumed it or not. All of these are put 0 anyway. So these ones also have to be 0. So maybe I should put Kp equal to 0 right here. So that means that if that is the case, if this is the solution, if this is the solution to this as well, because this one is same as this, so if this is the solution to this as well, that means that, hey, the only possible solution for this one is K1 through Kp being equal to 0. So if that's the case, then means that, hey, this subset which you are finding out here is linearly independent as well. And that's the proof of this theorem. And that's the end of this segment.